Hi friends, I welcome you for this e-Shikshana program conducted by VTU e-Learning Center. Myself, Dr. Mahesh Lohit KS, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Physics, ATME College of Engineering, Mysuru, here to discuss Module 3 of course Engineering Physics 18 PHY 12 bar 22. Today, in this introductory session, let us go through the topics that we are about to discuss in this particular module, and also let us have a brief introduction to the topics, and finally we shall know the mapped course outcomes and revised Bloom's taxonomy levels for this particular module. I consider this module to be made up of three chapters: Maxwell's equations, electromagnetic waves and optical fibers. In this chapter, Maxwell's equations, we discuss the fundamentals of vector calculus. Further, we discuss the necessary theorems which are required for the formulation of Maxwell's equations. We discuss the equation of continuity, which further leads to an important concept, displacement current density. And finally, we study the Maxwell's equations. At the end of this chapter, we solve some numerical problems related to divergence and curl. In the second chapter, electromagnetic waves, we derive an equation for electromagnetic waves in terms of electric field in vacuum. Then we study the plane electromagnetic waves in vacuum. Finally, we discuss the transverse nature of electromagnetic waves by studying the polarization of electromagnetic waves. In the chapter 3, that is optical fibers, we discuss about the propagation of light through the optical fibers, and we study the different quantities like acceptance angle and numerical aperture. We discuss about the types of optical fibers based on the modes of propagation and RI profile. We discuss attenuation, and this attenuation is due to the fiber losses. And finally, we discuss about the point to point communication using optical fibers. And at the end, we solve some numerical problems in this topic. So, what are Maxwell's equations? James Clerk Maxwell, in the year 1865, in his publication A Dynamical Theory of the Electromagnetic Field, provided the final formulation of Maxwell's equations in the mathematical form. Maxwell's equations are set of equations that govern the relationship between interacting electric and magnetic fields. And these Maxwell's equations are based on the Gauss law of electrostatics, Gauss law of magnetism, Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction and Maxwell-Ampere law. Based on the Maxwell's equation, Maxwell put forward the electromagnetic theory of light. According to this electromagnetic theory, light is made up of time varying electric and magnetic fields, and these electric and magnetic field variations are in mutually perpendicular directions and perpendicular to the direction of propagation. For example, if electric field is along y axis, then the magnetic field will be along z axis and the direction of propagation is along x axis. Based on this electromagnetic theory, Maxwell could able to explain the wave properties of light like interference, diffraction and polarization. And from polarization, it is evident that light waves are transverse in nature. In the last chapter in this particular module, we study the principle and construction of optical fiber, and we discuss about the fiber as a light guide. Optical fiber guides light using the phenomena of total internal reflection. There are three types of optical fibers, the classification of which is based on the modes of propagation and the RI profile. And also, when the optical signal propagates through the optical fiber, it gets progressively reduced due to fiber losses. So, that is called as attenuation. And finally, we discuss the point-to-point communication, how optical fiber could be used to communicate between two points. Okay? So, this is about the introduction to the topics that we discuss under this particular module 3. Now, let us know the mapped course outcome and RBT levels. In engineering physics curriculum, there are 5 course outcomes, and course outcome 2, CO2, is mapped to this particular module. Once students complete this particular module, they should be able to realize the interrelation between time varying electric and magnetic fields, the transverse nature of electromagnetic waves, and their role in optical fiber communication. So, this particular course outcome is mapped to the module 3. And also, 2 Bloom's taxonomy levels are mapped to this particular module. There are 6 levels, and the lowest level is remembering, and the next level is understanding, and these 2 levels are mapped to this particular module. I wrap up this session with a quote by James Clerk Maxwell. It is a good thing to have 2 ways of looking at a subject and to admit that there are 2 ways of looking at it. With this, we complete this session. Thank you very much.